In this simulation, we compare two compressors or two turbines that have different efficiencies. We can select the efficiencies here. There's two ways of comparing. So first we're looking at comparing for the same outlet pressure. So the same feed pressure and temperature to each compressor. And to get to the same outlet pressure when the efficiency is 60%, requires going to a higher temperature than if the efficiency is 80%. And what this means, of course, is we have to put more work into the compressor to raise to the same pressure when we have a lower efficiency, and more work means we have a higher outlet temperature. If we select the temperature option, then we're comparing at the same outlet temperature and calculating what is the outlet pressure for each of these simulations. And then we can do the same thing for a turbine where we're starting at high pressure and going to low pressure and we're getting work out. And if we have a more efficient turbine, we're going to get more work out. Of course, this efficiency is relative to a reversible turbine or a reversible compressor. So let's look at the interactive simulation, observe the behavior. So here we're looking at the interactive simulation. And for example, we can make the efficiency 1 for one of the compressors. So that's the reversible case. So now we're comparing how much work reversibly compressed from 2 bar to 10 bar. 5.1 kilojoules versus if 60% efficiency, 8.5 kilojoules. Notice the much higher temperature because we're putting much more work into the system. If we compare at the same outlet temperature, then you can see we get to much higher pressure for efficiency of 1 than efficiency of 0.6. Notice we have the same outlet temperature, which means we must have the same work because enthalpy change is equal to the work. And if we're looking at ideal gas, the enthalpy only depends on temperature and we have the same temperature change. We can, of course, change what outlet temperature we end up with, and higher outlet temperature means we put more work into it and therefore we have a higher pressure. If we now look at a turbine, we're going from high pressure to low pressure. Here I've picked the case where the outlet temperature is the same. So for a turbine, we're getting to a lower pressure when it's inefficient. In other words, we have to drop the pressure more to get the same work out. We're going to the same final temperature, so the work is the same. And that requires us to lower the pressure more when the turbine is less efficient. And so we can compare different efficiencies for either constant outlet temperature or, as more commonly done, constant outlet pressure. And so for the more efficient turbine, we get more work out going to 2 bar. And if we get more work out, we have a lower final temperature. We've taken more enthalpy out of the gas. And so this comparison between turbines of different efficiencies hopefully gives you a little better understanding of how they work and what the energy balance is for a turbine.